look.
What's up mga kakote, it's me Kuya Jet. Welcome sa Quadernos where learning is the name of the game. At kung bago ka pa lang sa aming YouTube channel, pindutin mo ng subscribe, like, and share button para maging updated ka sa aming videos. What's up mga kakote? Welcome na naman sa isang educational vlog kung saan ipagpapatuloy natin ang discussion about sa Arts Grade 10. Ayan, at magpapatuloy natin yung simulan natin nung previous vlog. So, ito yung regarding sa expressionism. So, ito yung mga learning objectives natin for today. It is to discuss what is Dadaism and to explore the surrealism. So, ito, what is Dadaism? So, Dada was literary artistic movement that originated in Europe during the time of the horrors of World War I. So, yan, habang sa gitna ng World War I, merong nabuong isang art style. So, yan, ito yung Dadaism. So, the repulsion of war brought several artists, writers, and intellectuals together. So, dahil sa war, nagkaroon ng magkakaisa ang mga writers and another artist. So, most of them were French and German nationalities who found themselves congregating in the refuge that Zurich in neutral Switzerland offered. So, they expressed their anger through an artistic tradition of protesting. And so, kung hindi daw nagkaroon ng World War I, ay hindi ma-form yung Dadaism. So, ito yung mga characteristics of Dadaism. So, it had only one rule. Never follow any known rules. Ayan. So, gumawa ka ng panibagong mong rules. So, its art was intended to provoke an emotional reaction from the viewer. So, typical shock and outrage. Ayan. So, ito yung mga arts na nakakagulat talaga nung time na yon. So, it was nonsensical to the point of being whimsical. Although, almost all members who created it were fiercely serious. So, habang dinodrawing nila ito, syempre, World War yun, nakatakot, yan, puno ng pangamba yung mga painters during this time. So, there was no predominant mediums and styles in Dadaist art. Yan, so, they use assemblage, collage, photomontage, and the use of ready-made objects among others. Yun. So, dito na nabuo yung mga collage na ginagamit natin recently. Ayan, sa yung photomontage din, yung mga mosaic. Ayan, nandito rin. So, did you know that this European artist had a hard time agreeing on the name of their project? Ayan, so nahihirapan silang gumawa yung mga kasama dito. So, they thought of Dada, which some say means hobby horse in French. Yan, yun yung meaning, hobby horse. So, others felt it was just baby talk and became a catchphrase that made the least amount of sense. So, Dada it was. Ayan, so, di ba yung mga babies, Dada, yung mga sinasabi nila sa kanilang mga tatay, di ba, Dada, ganon. Yun yung tawag nila sa kanilang mga daddy. So, meron tayo ditong famous artist na nakilala nung time ng Dadaism. So, siya si Hannah Hawk. Hannah Hawk is known for her collages and photomontage out of newspaper and magazine clipping. And so, doon niya linalagay yung kanyang mga art forms. She also integrated the use of sewing and craft designs. Ayan. So, hindi lang siya sa papers na nagdo-drawing yan. Gumagawa rin siya ng mga arts and crafts. So, she humiliated the German culture by literally slicing apart its imagery and resembling it into vivid, disjointed, emotional expressions of modern life. Ayan, kung ano yung panahon, kung ano yung buhay meron nung World War I, yun yung mga ginagawa niya. So, look at her artwork dito, yan. So, as she refers to the debauchery, corruption, and sexism of the pre-war German culture. Yan. So, ayan. Ito yung cut with a kitchen knife through the beer belly of the Weimar Republic in 1919. So, by Hannah Hawk. So, makita natin dito na yung beer belly of cutting knife, diba yan. So, ano nga ba ibig sabihin ng collage? So, collage came from the French word coiler, which means to glue. Yan. So, ito yung mga ginagawa natin, diba? Mahilig tayo gumawa ng mga collage nung mga pinapa-project pa sa atin nung elementary days. Ayan. So, it is a technique of art production wherein a piece of art is made by sticking different materials together such as photographs or pieces of paper or fabric. Ayan, to form one image, yun. So, ano naman yung photomontage? So, photomontage is the process and the result of making a composite photograph by cutting, gluing,
rearranging and overlapping of two or more photographs into a new image. It is often used as a means of expressing political dissent. Ayan, so yun yung pinagkaiba ng collage sa photomontage.
So, we proceed to surrealism. So, katatapos lang natin sa Dadaism and now we proceed to surrealism. So, ang keyword lang sa Dadaism, it is all about the World War I. Yun, yung mga art forms na nabuo doon. Yun. So, doon tumakbo yung mga pagiging malikhain ng ating mga artists noong time na yun.
Surrealism is a cultural movement that began in the 1920s. Yan, it was noted for its visual artworks and writings. Surrealism exhibits principles, ideas, or practices of producing fantastic or incongruous imagery or effects in art, literature, film, or theater by means of unnatural or irrational juxtapositions and combinations. The surrealist paints discomforting illogical scenarios with photographic precision and creates strange creatures from everyday objects. Surrealism also shows painting techniques that allow the unconscious to express itself. It aims to unlock the power of imagination.
So, di ba nga yung expressionism is ginawa in order to express one's emotions or feelings. So, yan. So, dito, obvious naman na pinakita sa surrealism yung pag-express ng kanilang emotions and feelings. So, what is juxtaposition? So, juxtaposition means the art or an instant of placing two or more things side by side, often to compare or contrast or to create an interesting effect. So, yun yung ibig sabihin ng juxtaposition.
So, the following are some of the key figures who influenced the concept of surrealism. So, una-una, meron tayo si André Breton. So, André Breton proposed that artists should avoid reason and rationality by accessing their unconscious mind. So, in practice, these methods became known as automatism or automatic writing. Yun yung na-form, which allowed art to forego conscious thought and embrace chance when creating art. So, next, the ideologies of Karl Marx influenced the surrealists, wherein they hoped that the mind had the power to reveal the contradictions in the everyday world and spore on evolution. So, their focus is on the power of personal imagination that somehow puts them in the tradition of Romanticism. However, they believe that revelations could be found on the streets and in everyday life. Ayan, so the work of Sigmund Freud was profoundly influential by surrealists also as well, particularly in his book. Title ng book niya ay yung The Interpretation of Dreams, written and published in 1899. Freud legitimized the significance of dreams and unconscious as valid revelations of human emotions and desires. His revealing of the complication and suppressed inner worlds of sexuality, desire, and violence provided a theoretical basis for much of surrealism. So, yan. So, again, ito lang yung tatandaan natin kay André Breton. So, André Breton was a French writer, poet, and artist fascist. Yan. So, he is known best as the founder of surrealism. His writings include the first surrealist manifesto, or yung Manifeste de Surrealisme, in which he defined surrealism as pure psychic automatism. So, next, we proceed to Karl Marx ulit. So, Karl Marx was a Prussian-born philosopher, economist, sociologist, journalist, and revolutionary socialist. Ayan, so kung ikaw ay isang grade 11 UM student, ayan, so bidang-bida dyan si Karl Marx. Marami siyang contribution sa ating mundo. And so, surrealist imagery is probably the most recognizable element of the movement, yet it is also the most elusive to categorize and define. It was observed that the nature is the most frequent imagery in the subjects of surrealism.
So, dito, makikita natin na puro nature lang daw yung magiging subject ng imagery na ito. What's up mga kote, thank you for listening and God bless you all and thank you nga pala sa ating winners na si Raven Achenza na nanalo ng isang Lightborn ni Granger, ayan sa Mobile Legends. So dito makikita na sa next vlog natin yung social realism and yung some art forms pa. So bye, because learning is the name of the game.